Hi, it's Kelly and welcome back to MeMore TV. Today's video, I'm here shooting at Box Clever Sports and I'm going to share with you the benefits of boxing for women and how to get started. So to help me with that, I'm with Pete Liggins, founder of Box Clever Sports. Where it all started for me. Where did it start for you, Pete?
It started for me when I was probably about 8 years old, really. So I was I wanted to box with my dad, watching it on TV, and realised that was the sport that I wanted to get involved in. And so I asked my mum, and my mum told me that it's against the law. It's not against the law. She said it's against the law until you're 13. So 13 years old on my birthday, walked into my mum's room, and I said, right, that's it. And she said, okay. So she gave up trying to stop me from doing it. And then my dad took me down the gym.
And so you competed, didn't you? Did you?
Yeah, I competed since I trained up for 2 years. Then I started my competitive matches at 15. And then just kept going until this year. I took some time out in between, so I took about 6 years out and then another year out where I focused on this place and like building up the business, and then tried to get back into the boxing gym and at my old age, which was all right, but it was hard going, but it was great fun.
So you took a little hiatus there and you went to university?
Went to uni. I was still boxing when I was at uni, entering the university championships and obviously doing the ABAs, like the national championships and so forth. The dream was to go pro, become world champion, and then, you know, and go from there and, you know, live the high life as a professional boxer. But it kind of, the highlight of, you know, you see the glamorous side of boxing, but it's not as glamorous as it makes out. You know, that 2% that make it, you know, they're the ones that kind of get the, you know, all the fame and all the glitz. And realistically, you know, it's a tough sport to make a living out of. After uni, I definitely realized when I looked at the offer for the contract, and I was just like, it wasn't worth me personally putting, you know, going through all the training, holding another job, and then, you know, the damage that I could potentially do to myself. So I stepped away from that, and then from there, I started coaching kids. So I was like, okay, started working for a youth offending team, picking up kids from the house, mentoring them. It was more about creating that bond with the kids, because these were kids that were on the risk of behavioural problems. So it was kind of building up that bond with them, keeping them focused, and the discipline that boxing instills to kids, and the confidence and the social aspects that are involved in it. So it was putting all those aspects into the child, and also, you know, trying to change the path they could have possibly been going down. And then from there, that's kind of where I got the idea to set up Box Clever. I was like, okay, there's definitely, I felt like I could do more. So I set the Box Clever up, and it was directly involved to go to schools. So that's why it was called Box Clever, because I thought it would be great for a school program. And then the sports part was, you know, if we ever wanted to go down another avenue and put, you know, basketball or football or something like that, because, you know, Box Clever can be taken from different streams. You put it into someone in a box and you've got to find, you know, you can box clever, you've got different aspects or different angles of that box.
I like that.
So that's how it all came about. That was the original idea of the name. And then, you know, obviously it's got the, would it, right word be double entendre. You've got to have your ring smarts, and you've also got to be able to apply those ring smarts in life. So that's why I went into schools, and that's why it was called what it was.
So how long has it been? How long have you been running?
We've been running since 2008, February 2008, but it was started off way before that. And then from there, I've always coached adults since I was, I think, about 14, 15. I was coaching adults at like a box fit sort of community hall program.
Was there a lot of women involved then?
Back then, there weren't that many. I mean, boxing is kind of, I think, you know, it's kind of, it depends on where it's being held. I think any boxing gym, you know, it was in 95 that women were only allowed to start to compete, to box. So it was very slow on the uptake. And then, you know, boxing clubs themselves were very much shut doors to the public. You could only go into a gym if you were there to box. And it's, you know, there's relative amount to that today, but women are much more involved in boxing. You know, everyone's much more aware that women are allowed to box, that they can compete, and that they're fantastic at it.
Especially here, there's, you know, you've got a high percentage of women that are coming here to box, me included. But so what are the benefits for women? the benefits of boxing.
The benefits, I think the benefits of boxing are that I think there's a massive misconception that boxing, you know, you're going to get big, you're going, you know, it's only an upper body sport, when in reality it's the complete opposite. You know, the punch actually starts from the feet and it works its way up, but the main amount of power is coming from the legs and the trunk. So, you know, the arm's the extension of the punch. There's not much, you know, not much mass force coming from the upper body. It's all deriving from the lower body. And that's what makes it a full body sport, because you have to have everything in balance. Everything has to be in tune. You can't just work on one angle. You have to have your body in symmetry to be able to be good and compete at the sport.
A lot of men and women actually in the medical field, friends, when I say I box, and they go, "Oh, no, women aren't made for boxing."
Yeah.
Or I get, "Oh, your shoulders, it can't be good for your shoulders."
Yeah.
When I used to have quite a bit of pain in my shoulders, and since boxing, they've improved.
Okay, great.
You know, which again, just misconceptions of boxing. But I also find there's a mental side to boxing. It's a release. Mm. It's, you know, you must have a lot of people come in, you know, you could have a bad day, you come in here, you get to just let all that out.
It's a great stress relief. I mean, it's, you know, going back onto the shoulder aspect, I mean, as long as you do the correct mobility work, then you won't have any problems. You know, I'm not going to say, you know, you do have to stretch, you have to mobilize your body. You know, you don't want to be hunched over. You see that with, you know, a few boxers, but you get the right training in, and you're going to bring yourself back, and it's going to help with your posture. And then also it's going to give you fantastic shoulders. So it's not a case of it, you know, making it muscly. It will give you a great definition of the shoulders. So it's, and that's the key of boxing. It's about giving you a great defined body in every muscle area.
What I've found, mixing this with, you know, hot yoga and things that I do, it really it's body shaping.
Yeah.
It changes the shape.
Yeah, it's a full body condition. It's a full body tone. So it's, you know, it's not putting on mass bulk.
And the other thing that I'm loving is the strength. Mm-hmm. You know, I feel stronger, which is my motto as I get older. Stronger, longer.
Yeah, so yeah. Yeah.
I'll last longer. But I also feel, you know, there's a self-defense aspect of it. If I was attacked or someone was to come at me, I've got a few moves up my sleeve, you know?
Yeah.
And that's empowering.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, well, this is, you know, going back to when I was talking about the kids, I mean, it is, you know, it's a confidence boost. You know, it's, you know, it gives everybody, you know, whether you're a child to, you know, and a teenager or an adult, it gives you that awareness and that self-confidence to be able to carry yourself. And that gives you that demeanor, that aura to be like, okay, I know, you know, I know I can handle myself. I'm not going to, you know, you're not going to be silly and go down a dark alley. But, you know, if anything was to happen, you know, you know how to look after yourself. You know how to throw that right hand and then run away.
Yeah.
So, you know, and you're fit enough to run as well. So then you can do that. And that's, you know, so that's it. I mean, no, the self-esteem and confidence that it brings with it, you know, is massive.
And you said, and you know, fit enough to run as well. It's the cardio.
I actually just done a strength conditioning course over the weekend, and it's like 60 or 75%. Aerobic. Being able to work your body to that extreme benefits on your cardio system, you know, your heart, your lungs, you know, producing the pumping the oxygen through the body, getting up. What I find these days is a lot of people are so focused and so aware of being physically fit and looking, you know, on the externally how good they're going to look. You know, for guys it's how muscly they are, for women, you know, to be in a certain, have a flat tummy or whatever it is. But if you're not looking after yourself inside, it doesn't matter how good you are on the outside. My dad always said to me, you can have a rubbish car, but if your engine's good, it's gonna take you forever. With the cardio that's involved in boxing, you know, it's a huge benefit to everybody.
And the other thing I find too is when I'm boxing, I mean, I'm here, I'm present, and I have to be because I am focused because of the coordination.
Mm.
And you guys are calling, you know, my different.
Yeah.
Three, two, a hook, uppercut. I mean, it's great to get my brain a little bit active.
It gets the synapses flowing. You know, it's a great stress relief, obviously, if you've had a bad day at the office and you just want to fire out, get rid of whatever the demons are, you can get that out in the bag. It's like a game of chess. Everyone refers to boxing as chess. You've got to think two or three moves ahead. You've got to think about where your feet, your hands are, your movement, what shot they're going to throw. So it's not a case of just going in there and it being barbaric and going forwards and trying to hurt each other. It's actually very technical. You know, that's why they call it the sweet science.
When you started, you worked with a lot of young offenders and children that really have benefited from your training and boxing. But I also know my 12-year-old daughter benefits from this, and you have a class for 12 to 15-year-olds, and I have seen her confidence grow. Tell me a little bit more about that.
The gym was originally based in Grenfell Tower, which is a social housing block of flats, which obviously, due to the tragedy, they came back here, we kind of worked together with the community, the Dell Youth Boxing Club, they came back here. And that's what we're about. We're not about being yet another gym who's rolling out classes and just doing personal training and so forth. We're about bringing all the aspects together so everybody, children and adults and amateur boxers, can all train together.
The benefits of boxing are just huge. Whether it's your fitness, whether it's coordination, whether it's a mental release, and the coordination, I know how much it has changed my mind, set, and my body. Pete, thank you. That was a great insight to boxing and the benefits of boxing, especially for women. I'll link Pete's Box Clever Sports in the description below. And remember, I make lots of other videos on paleo, beauty and lifestyle, so please subscribe. And you can find me on social media at memore.tv. Take three.